You're very beautiful, Anastasia Steele. I can't wait to be inside you. Holy shit! His words! He's so seductive. He takes my breath away. Show me how you pleasure yourself. What? I frown. Don't be coy, Anna. Show me, he whispers. I shake my head. I don't know what you mean. My voice is hoarse. I hardly recognize it, laced with desire. How do you make yourself come? I want to see. I shake my head. I don't. I mumble. He raises his eyebrows, astonished for a moment, and his eyes darken, and he shakes his head in disbelief. Well, we have to see what we can do about that. His voice is soft, challenging. Water break. Challenging, a delicious sensual fret. He undoes the buttons of his jeans and slowly pulls his jeans down. His eyes on mine the whole time. He leans down over me and grasping each of my ankles. Quickly jerks my legs apart and crawls into the bed between my legs. He hovers over me. I am squirming with knees. Keep still, he murmurs. And then he leans down and kisses the inside of my thigh. Trailing kisses up over the thin lacy material of my panties, kissing me. Oh, I can't keep still. How can I not move? I wriggle beneath him. We're gonna have to work on keeping you still, baby. He trail kisses on my belly. He trail kisses on my belly. And his tongue deeps into my navel. Still, he's heading north, kissing me across my torso. My skin is burning. I'm flushed. Too hot. Too cold. And I'm clawing at the sheet. Clowning at the sheet? I'm clawing at the sheet. Beneath me, he lies down beside me and his hand trails up from my hip, to my waist, and up to my breast. And he gazes down on me, his expression unreadable, and gently cups my breasts. You fit my head perfectly, Anastasia. He murmurs and dips his index finger into the cup of my bra, and gently yanks it down. Free my breasts, but the underwire and fabric of the cup force it upward. His finger moves to my other breast and repeats the process. Water break. My breasts swell, and my nipples harden under his steady gaze. I am thrust up on my own bra. Very nice, he whispers a prayer initially. And my nipples harden even more. He blows very gently on one of his hands, moves to my other breast. And his thumb slowly rolls the end of my nipple, elongating it. I groan, feeling the sweet sensation all the way to my groin. I am so wet. Oh, please. I beg internally as my fingers clasp the sheet tighter. He slips close around my other nipple, and when he tugs, I nearly convulse. Let's see if we can make you come like this, he whispers. Continuous, slow, sensual assault. My nipples bear the delicious brunt of his deft fingers and lips, setting all light. Every single nerve ending so that my whole body sings with the sweet agony. He just doesn't stop. Oh, please, I beg. I pull my head back. My mouth open as I groan, my legs stiffening. Holy hell, what's happening to me? Let's go, baby, he murmurs, his teeth close around my nipple, and his thumb and finger pull hard, and I fall apart in his hands, my body convulsing and shattering into 1,000 pieces. He kisses me, deeply, his tongue in my mouth absorbing my cries. Oh my, that was extraordinary. Now I know what all the fuss is about. He gazes down at me, a satisfied smile on his face. Well, I'm sure there's nothing but gratitude and awe on mine. You are very responsive, he breathes. You're going to have to learn to control that. It's going to be so much fun teaching you how. He kisses me again. My breathing is still ragged as I come down from my orgasm. His hand moves down my waist to my hips and then cups me intimately. Jeez. His fingers slip through the fine lace and slowly circles around me, There! Briefly, he closed his eyes and his breathing hitches. You are so You're so deliciously wet. God, I want you. He thrusts his fingers inside me and I cry out as he does it again and again. He pulls my clitoris and I cry out once more. He pushes inside me harder and harder still. I grow. Suddenly he hits and tucks my panties off and throws them on the floor. Pulling off his boxer brief, his erection springs free. Holy cow. Probably not the best moment to drink water. He reaches over to his bedside table and grabs a foil packet. The fuck? And then he moves between my legs, spreading them further apart. He kneels up and pulls a condom onto his considerable length. Oh no. Will it? How? Don't worry, he breathes, his eyes on mine. You expand too. He leans down, his hands on either side of my head. So he's hovering over me, staring down into my eyes. Stare at me, bitch. Stare at it. His jaw clenches, eye burning. It's only now that I register he's still wearing his shirt. You really want to do this? He asks softly. Please, I beg. Pull your knees up, he orders softly, and I'm quick to obey. I'm going to fuck you now, Miss Steele. He murmurs as he positions the head of his erection at the entrance of my sex. Hard, he whispers, and he slaps all into me. Ah! I cry as I feel a weird pinching sensation deep inside me as he rips through my virginity. He still gazes down at me. His eyes rise with ecstatic traffic. Ecstatic triumph. His mouth is open slightly and his beam is harsh. He groans. You're so tight. You okay? I nod, my eyes wide, my hands on his forearms. I feel so full. He stays still, letting me acclimatize to the intrusive, overwhelming feeling of him inside me. I'm going to move, baby, he breathes after a moment, his voice tight. Oh! He eases backwards and shrugs his shoulders, and he closes his eyes and groans, and thrusts into me again. I cry out a second time, and he stills. More? He whispers, his voice raw. Yes! I breathe. He does it once more and stills again. I groan, my body accepting him. Oh, I want this! Again! He breathes. Yes! It's a plea. Then he moves, but this time he doesn't stop. He shifts into his elbow so I can feel his weight on me. Holding me down! He moves slowly at first, easing himself in and out of me. And as I grow accustomed to the alien feeling, my hips move gently to meet his. He speeds up, I moan, and he pounds on, picking up speed, merciless, a relentless rhythm, and I keep up, meeting his thrust. He grabs my head between his hands and kisses me hard, his teeth pulling my lower lip again. He shifts slightly, and I can feel something building deep inside me. Like before, I start to stiffen as he thrusts on and on. My body quivers, bows, a sheen of sweat gathers over me. Oh my, I didn't know it would feel like this. Didn't know it could feel as good as this. My thoughts are scattering. There's only sensation. Only him. Only me. Oh please, I stiffen. Come for me, Anna, he whispers breathlessly, and I unravel his word, exploding around as I climax and splintering into a million pieces underneath him. As he comes, he calls on my hand, thrusting hard, then stealing as he empties himself into me. I am still panting, trying to slow my breathing, my thumping heart, and my thoughts are in vicious disarray. Wow, that was astounding. I open my eyes, and he has his forehead pressed against me. His eyes closed, his breathing ragged Christian Christian's eyes flicker open and gaze down at me, dark but soft. He's still inside me, leaning down. He gently presses a kiss against my forehead and slowly pulls out of me. Oh, I wince at the unfamiliarity. Did I hurt you, Christian asks as he lies down beside me propped up on one elbow. He tucks a stray strand of my hair beside my ear, and I have to grin wildly. You're asking me if you hurt me. The irony's not lost on me. He smiles sardonically. Seriously, are you okay? His eyes are intense, probing, demanding even. I stretch out beside him, feeling loose limb. My bones like jelly, but I'm relaxed. Deeply relaxed. I grin at him. I can't stop grinning. Now I know what all the fuss is about. Two orgasms coming apart at the seams, like the spin cycle on a washing machine. Wow, I had no idea what my body was capable of. Could be wound so tightly and released so violently, so gratifyingly. The pleasure was indescribable. You're biting your lip and you haven't answered me. He's frowning. I grin up at him impishly. He looks gorgeous with his tussled hair, burning our gray eyes and serious dark expression. I'd like to do that again, I whispered for a moment. I think I see a fiending look of relief on his face. Peter's foreign shutters come down, and he gazes at me through hooded eyes. Would you now, Miss Neal? He murmurs dryly. He leans down and kisses me very gently at the corner of my mouth. Demanding little things, aren't you? Turn on your front. I blink at him momentarily, and then I turn over. He unhooks my bra and runs his hands down my back to my head. Oh, my bad. Sneezing fit. He hooks my bra and runs his hand down my back to my foot behind. You really have the most beautiful skin, he murmurs. He shifts so that one of his legs pushes between mine and is half lying across my back. I can't feel the buttons of his shirt pressing into me as he gathers my hair off my face and kisses my bare shoulder. Why are you wearing your shirt? I ask. He stills. After a beat, he shuffles out of his shirt and he lies back down on me. I feel his warm skin against mine. It feels heavenly. He has a light dusting of hair across his chest, which tickles my back. So you want me to fuck you again? He whispers in my ears and he begins to trail feather-like kisses around my ear, down my neck. So, that's pretty much for now. Take it easy, guys. Till next time.